Hi everyone, in this video we will learn how to use PySpark with Google Colab. PySpark is the Python API for Apache Spark. It enables users to perform real-time, large-scale data processing in a distributed environment using Python. PySpark combines Python's learnability and ease of use with the power of Apache Spark to enable processing and analysis of data at any size for everyone familiar with Python. PySpark supports all of Spark's features such as Spark SQL, data frames, structured streaming, machine learning, and Spark Core. First, we will check if Java is installed in our Colab session. Java is required for Apache Spark because it is built on the Java virtual machine. We can check by running the shell command !java-version. We can see that Java is installed. To install PySpark, I will call pip install PySpark. Once PySpark is installed, I am going to import all of the Python modules that we will work with. Next, I am going to download a large dataset containing Amazon reviews using curl. After the download is complete, I need to unzip the data file into our content directory. Within the Google Colab session, it will take about 5 to 10 minutes to download the dataset. In the next cell, I am going to print out the size of the dataset using the OS module. We can see it is a fairly large dataset that is 8 gigabytes in size. Now we can initialize a Spark session. A Spark session is a class from the PySpark module. It is the entry point to working with Apache Spark. This will allow us to create a PySpark data frame. I will store the session in a variable named Spark, and from the Spark session, I will call builder name, the app name, which is automotive data, and I will create the session. I will also check the Spark version. We created our Spark session, and we can see that we are running Spark 3.5.1. Next, I am going to attempt to read in the JSON file using pandas. Given the large size of the file, I expect pandas to fail on the read. And we can see that our Colab session crashed because pandas cannot handle reading in the large file. I am going to run all of the cells before this one, and we will move on to reading the data into a PySpark data frame. Now we can move on to trying to read the data into a PySpark data frame. To do this, I will first create a Spark schema. Within Apache Spark, a schema provides the data format for a data frame or a data set. For our schema, we will first use our struct type, which is a set of struct fields. A struct field contains information for a given column, including the column name, the type of data within the rows, which is the data type, and whether or not the row can contain a null value, which is nullable. We have our schema set. Let us run the cell. Now we will read the file using our schema into a PySpark data frame, which I will call SparkDF. And we have created our PySpark data frame. Let us run a few operations on the data frame. First, I will call the show function, which will display the first 5 rows of the data frame. Next, I will call print schema, which will print the columns and data types of the data frame. Calling the describe function will retrieve summary statistics for the data frame. Finally, I want to retrieve the counts of all the ratings across the products within my data frame. And we were able to get the counts. In the final section, I am going to touch on some of the limitations of PySpark within Google Colab. Google Colab provides a platform to Google account holders for no additional monetary fee. Because of this, resources within Google Colab are limited. Additionally, the computation will be slower because of cloud latency. For example, running the PySpark describe function on a dedicated virtual machine took only a minute and 32 seconds, while in Google Colab, running the function took almost 17 minutes. For the free edition of Google Colab, using PySpark can be great for learning PySpark or working with early stage prototype scripts. However, the free version of Google Colab should not be used for development or production purposes. Consider working with datasets 2 gigabytes or smaller in Google Colab when using Spark. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. I included references if you want to learn more about PySpark. If you found the video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. Thanks again, everyone, and happy coding.